Our next guest tonight is a member of the Board of the Directors of the Jethsuby Scholarship Fund. He was born and raised in San Antonio, where he attended Catholic schools, graduating from Central Catholic High School. He received a bachelor's degree in business and master's degree in business management from the University of Texas at Austin, and currently serves as vice president of sales with Pentec Health Corporation. This is the second year sitting on the board, and we are very pleased to have him with us tonight. He has an extraordinary story. Please welcome Robert Rodriguez.
Thank you, Cynthia. Your enthusiasm is contagious. It is an absolute pleasure to be standing here in front of all of you. But more importantly than me standing here in front of all of you is all these wonderful children and the scholarships they've received. I think that's fantastic, and you should be very proud of yourself. Another round of applause, please. Let me tell you my story about Catholic school. It's an interesting story. Like Cynthia said, I am from San Antonio, but my story didn't start in San Antonio. It started in all places in Michigan. My wife's from Michigan. We have a place, we vacation in Michigan. Love it out there, wonderful weather, it's a great place, wonderful. And I was trying to get my dad to come up and visit with us. 6, 7, last 8 years, he wouldn't want to come. Didn't want anything to do with Michigan. Kind of interesting. Finally, I said, Bob, I'll buy you a ticket, you and Mom. 7, 8 years later, I'm getting you a ticket. If you want to come, great, if not, I understand, but here's your airplane ticket. I hope you go. Where am I flying to? Traverse City, Michigan, because our place is by Traverse City, Michigan. Right, beautiful city, wonderful, right on the lake. He goes, you know, the last time I was in Traverse City, Michigan, was as a migrant worker. See, I picked cherries in Michigan. That was my memory of Michigan. It's a little different than yours. And he did it as a child. From 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th grade, my dad and his whole family got into a truck, drove up to Michigan, and picked cherries with his mom, his dad, and his 8 or 9 siblings. And that's all they made their money for the summer. And my dad one day said, you know what? As wonderful as this is, I don't think it's a path I want my children to follow. I don't. I want them to be able to choose different paths. And he felt that in his mind, the best way to do that was to provide us an education. Not just any education, but a Catholic education. And he made a promise to my mom when he married her, that's exactly what he would do. His children would get a Catholic education. So if they didn't want to pick cherries, they can choose something else to do. He was in 4th grade. There's a lot of 4th graders here tonight. If you were with my dad's family, you would be here tonight. You'd be in Michigan picking cherries. So one of the good reasons I went to Catholic school was my father. When I tell you about another reason, another very influential person in my life was my grandfather. On my mom's side, he was from Cuba. And when Castro took over, he was not a communist. And if you're not a communist in Cuba, you kind of lose it all. And so he ended up coming to the United States with nothing but a little bitty yellow suitcase. Because when he left Cuba, they took everything from him. They took his house, his cars, his dishes, his cups, his plates, his salt and pepper shakers. They had nothing but a little bitty suitcase. He was 55 years old. Can you imagine leaving and having to start all over at 55 years old? Oh, and don't speak the language. So he comes over, and in 2 years, learns English, takes his test, and his exams. Why is that important? Here's the point he made to me. In Cuba, they took everything away from me. But you know what they didn't take? What I put up here. You see, my grandfather was a doctor. So he came here, he learned English, he took his boards, passed all his exams, and at the age of 57, started practicing medicine again in the U.S. And he stressed to us every single time we saw him, no one takes an education away from you. It's the best thing you can do for yourself. No one can ever take it away from you, and you can rebuild your life around it. 57, he starts practicing medicine again, retires 11 years later with more money than he ever thought he'd ever make in his lifetime. The American dream. So I have my grandfather, who says, the importance of a Catholic education. I will work with your dad, and I will make sure you and your brothers go to Catholic school. And that's exactly what they did. They sent my brothers and I to Catholic school. Catholic grade school, Catholic high school. I ended up going to the University of Texas at Austin. My brothers went to A&M. Don't hold that against them. It's a good school, wonderful school. But the purpose of the Catholic education is, like has been said here before, and I've heard it several times, get to college and get to heaven. It's exactly what it's done for my brothers and I. I'm happy to be a vice president of sales of a major healthcare company. It's not always an easy job, but it's a challenging one. My brother Adolfo is a physician. He's an emergency room physician. He works for the State Department at the big Air Force Base in Germany, Landshut. And Rogelio, my younger brother, is an investment banker and putting all sorts of deals together for cities and states and stuff like that. We are all products of the Catholic education. I'm very proud of it. I'd like to leave you all with something today, especially the little kiddos that won the scholarships. You can't do it alone, and it's okay for us for help. My brothers and I never would have gotten to the place we are today without people around us helping us. My grandparents, my father. I always thank my father, my mother, and I always thank my abuelo and my abuela, because without them, I wouldn't be here today. Thank you very much for your time. I do appreciate it. Once again, congratulations on what you've accomplished. It's awesome. You should be proud. God bless and have a great rest of the evening.